Hello, I'm Jack. Welcome to my channel, Practical Programming with Dr. Su. In this video series, you will learn everything you need to get started with wgpu graphics programming in Rust. In the last video, I explained how to add the lighting effect to a 3D sphere. In this video, I will show you how to add the lighting effect to a 3D torus, as shown here. A torus can be created by rotating a circle in 3D space about a specified axis. It can be described by a set of parametric equations. Here, the capital R represents the radius of the torus from center to the radius here. And the small r here represents the radius of the circle here. Here, u and v are parametric variables. To obtain the vertex position data, here we can divide its surface using the cube rings and the torus ring, this ring and the torus ring, to form the surface grids, as shown here. The unit cell for the torus is a quadrilateral, A, B, C, D. It can be divided into two triangles, A, B, C, and C, D, A. Here, we will use parametric equations to calculate the positions on the torus surface. We then add the vertex data for the six vertices of this two triangle for each unit cell. Now we discuss how to calculate the normal vector for this quadrilateral unit cell, A, B, C, D. For a general quadrilateral, A, B, C, D, its four vertices may not be in the same plane. We can divide it into two triangles, A, B, C, C, D, A. We can calculate its surface normals in two steps. First, we calculate the weighted normal for each triangle, which is weighted by the area of that triangle. The triangle with larger area will get more weight. As we know, the area of a triangle is proportional to its cross product of two sides. You can see here, for triangle ABC, its area proportional to cross product is two sides, is BC, BC, and CA, CA. These two side cross products. And for the triangle CDA, we have BC cross CA. Next step is to calculate the surface normal from the weighted triangle normal here. That is, the surface normal equals to the sum of these two products. Surface normal equals the sum of two weighted normal, and then normalize it to 1. You can see we can just the summation of these two products. You can see surface normal equals normalize these two cross products. Finally, we get normalized cross products CA and DB, CA and DB. This means this quadrilateral normal just equals the product of these two diagonal lines, CA and DB. We will use this formula to calculate the light model for 3D torus surface. Okay, now let's go to the programming part. Here we will use the Gate tool to clone the source code used in the last example, and then make corresponding changes to that source code to build the project used in this video. Now I start a Visual Studio Code directly from Windows Start menu from here. This is a Visual Studio Code interface. Now I start a new terminal window and cd into the code folder. From this folder, we make a new directory called wgpu12 and cd into it. We can then clone the source code used in the last video with the command git clone wgpu11. After this command, we leave a space and a period. This will place all our source code in the current folder. We can then run this command. We can check direct. You can see the source code is indeed in the current folder. Now we can open this folder from Visual Studio Code, open folder, code wgpu12. Here contains the source code used in the last video. Now from src folder, open the math func.rs file. We need to add a new function called Torus position to this file. Add here Torus position. We can use this function to calculate the point positions on the torus surface using the parametric equation described here. Now we can save this file and close it. Next, from src folder, open vertexdata.rs file. We need to add a new function called torusData to this file. As we discussed previously, in order to create a torus shape, we need to divide its surface using the cube rings and the torus rings. The unit cell for the torus is a quadrilateral with four vertices, as shown here. P0, P1, and P2, P3 is four vertices for each unit cell. Here we call the torus position to get the positions on the torus surface from mathfunc.rs file. We then add the vertex data for the six vertices of two triangles for each unit cell. You can see here we add six positions. My first triangle is P0, P1, P2. Second triangle is P2, P3, and P0. We add six positions for each unit cell. The normal vector for this quadrilateral can be calculated using the cross products of two diagonal lines. You can see here we first define two diagonal lines CA. We use P2 minus P0 here. And DB use P3 minus P1. Then we make a CA cross product and DB, and then normalize this cross product to get the normal vector CP. Each vertex of the two triangles on this unit cell has the same unit vector. You can see R has unit vector CP for these six vertices. So here we use the CP vector for these six vertices to get the normal vector data for each unit cell. The torus data function returns the positions and the normal vector data. Now we can save this file and close it. Next, we need to make some changes to the main.rs file. From src folder, open main.rs file. We need to replace its content with the new code. Here, we first introduce two modules, common and vertex data. We then define create vertices a function. Inside this function, we generate the position and the normal data by calling the torus data methods. This function returns vector of the vertex structure defined in the common.rs file. Finally, we define our main function, which is very simple because we place most code into the common.rs file. Here we just generate vertex data and light data and use this data to execute the common run function. Now we can save this file. Now we can run our example in the terminal window. Cargo run. Okay, here is our 3D torus with red color and a yellow specular light. We can make changes to our light parameters. For example, if we set diffuse and specular light intensity to 0 and set ambient intensity to 1, we will get a torus with ambient light only. Now close this window and change the light parameter here. Change the AI to 1 and change the diffuse intensity to 0 and the specular intensity to 0. And rerun the application. Right now, the torus only have the ambient light, so it looks flat and has no 3D feature. Let's change the parameter back. Close this window and change the parameter back. We can also change the diffuse light and the specular light color. For example, we change the color to green and change the specular light to white and rerun the application. You can see we get a torus with green color with white specular light. By following the procedure described here, you can add the lighting effect to your Win3D objects. First, define the mesh function that describes your object, then create vertex position data, and finally generate the normal vector data. Then you can easily add lighting effect to your 3D objects. Now I have completed this example. In next video, I will show you how to add color map to 3D surfaces. Thank you for watching.